Thursday Night Tailgate, where the spotlight is always on the positive. Tune in Thursday night from 8 to 10 p.m. Eastern Time to hear your favorite NFL legends, players, and coaches sharing their stories. Now back to Chris and Bob.
I wouldn't joke about anything else that happened to you tonight.
We are back here on Thursday Night Tailgate, and we're turning on our spotlight on the positive. Bob, who are you putting your spotlight on tonight?
Well, Chris, as you and I spoke during the week, I had tweeted something earlier this week about how Cameron Jordan was visiting high schools, actually on Tuesday. But he does it every Tuesday, Chris. So it's that was just one tweet of something he does all the time. I just wanted to bring attention to it. But I think we've mentioned him in the past because, let's face it, I think 2017 he was a finalist for the Walter Payton Man of the Year. He can probably do that every year, Chris, for the type of things he does, because on his days off, he's been doing this since 2011. He will either go to a high school, a grammar school down in that area, in New Orleans, or a hospital. It's something just he does all the time. And if you look at some of Cam's history, Chris, I don't think too many people, if they go back as far as you and I do, they'll remember his father played for the Minnesota Vikings, if people might remember, and he gives a lot of respect to his father, who was a tight end, and gives all the credit to him as far as why he still does what he does. And it's just great to see what he does, because again, this is every Tuesday. He doesn't have to do it. He often does it alone. Sometimes he'll take teammates with him. But it's just tremendous. And I also listened to an interview with him this week about kind of like why he does what he does. And he basically said, you know, it's easy to go to the pros and be able to try and give back to the generation. He just wants to get it across that he is not doing this because his dad did it, and he's not doing it for any kind of recognition. In fact, he kind of disdains the recognition. He just said, at the end of the day, I'm going to do it because it's just simply the right thing to do. It's a thing that if I can help a kid, it will come back to me. And again, I mean, it's just amazing to see what it does. His father was a Brown graduate. Obviously, there's a lot of intelligence in that family. And but this guy continues to do it, Chris. He started it in 2011. This is 8 years later, and that's what people are most impressed by, is that he's like the sunrise. He does it every day. So me tweeting about that is something that everyone already knew about, but I just wanted to remind him, when some people on their days off are just kind of resting, especially in the NFL, he'll be out of the hospital or a school doing what he does every Tuesday. So maybe people in the future can think about that. Every Tuesday morning, think about what Cam Jordan's doing. He's either, and sometimes you read about it, either a hospital or a school. So again, this guy, Chris, has become a favorite of ours just because of what we read about him. And a great athlete on the field. Let's not make any mistake of that. But what he does off the field really makes him a hero.
Yes, it does. And that's a great story. And you know, that's some of the great things that we love, is seeing how these guys give back to kids in hospitals or veterans in hospitals, and spending their off days, you know, trying to make people feel better, whatever the situation that they're dealing with. So kudos to Cam Jordan for all he's doing, Bob. Great stuff. I'm putting my spotlight tonight on 49ers offensive lineman Ben Garland. Earlier this year, he won the NFL Salute to Service Award for the great things that he does to support military veterans. He's an Air Force Academy grad. He served in the National Guard. Last year, he went over and did two tours with the USO, visiting our troops over in Italy, Germany, Iraq, and Kuwait. He works with veterans, helping them transition back to civilian life, those guys that are dealing with different situations, whether it's health, injuries, or PTSD. He also works with veterans and their families in a program called Turning the Tide on Veteran Suicide. So we hear an awful lot about the tragic stories about our veterans that are committing suicide. So he's getting involved there. Yeah, he is still a member of the Colorado Air National Guard. He donates his time and donates game tickets to active members there and to their families. He obviously gets called up from time to time to do exercises, so he's staying involved with the Air National Guard. When he was here in Atlanta, and he played for the Falcons for a few years prior to going to San Francisco this year, but he worked with the Georgia Tech ROTC members, inspiring and mentoring those kids. During the 49ers bye week earlier, and you talk about going back, Bob, he went back to Colorado to visit two local children's hospitals and spend time with the kids that he had formed relationships there, and also obviously, you know, new kids that have been admitted since then. He wants to give back to those kids and inspire them and spend some time with those kids that are dealing with a variety of different things. He's also donated $10,000 to help fight help with the fight with human trafficking. He donated $15,000 to the Water Boys organization. Bob, we've talked about, you know, all the different players that have gone back and been a part of that organization that Chris Long started, helping to try to bring fresh water to areas of Africa. He donated $5,000 to an organization called Top Dog that supplies service dogs to veterans that are dealing with PTSD as well. So a lot of great things that that Ben Garland is out there doing. So kudos to him for all the different things that he is doing to make a difference in people's lives, whether it's children, whether it's veterans, whether it's guys that are currently serving in the National Guard there in Colorado. What a great guy, and what a great, what a plethora of great things that he's doing.
Yeah, thanks for bringing him up, Chris. I think his name has come up on the show before, like Cam. So they continue to do it. And again, we can get different people every week, but these guys that, whose names keep coming up, you know that they've been doing it for a long time. But I salute Garland, too. That's a terrific story.
All right, my friend, it is time for us to go ahead and put a bow on this edition of Thursday Night Tailgate. We certainly want to send out our thanks again to Rod Smith, to Leonard Wheeler, to our good friend Tony Collins, being a part of the show every single week. Can't thank those guys enough for making tonight's show very special. And, Bob, always good to spend my Thursday nights with you, my friend.
You too, Chris. That was a lot of fun. And especially anytime we get a new guy and become friends with a new one like Mr. Smith, that was great. We hope that'll be a long time thing. But it's always an honor to work with you.
I appreciate you, my friend. Next week, come back and join us again, because we've got some really great friends coming back to be a part of the show. Former Bears defensive back Mark Carrier will join us, plus a couple of former Rams defensive back Leroy Irvin and our good friend Jim Everett will be here. And, of course, Tony Collins with our five-star picks of the week. So another outstanding show on tap for you next week. On social media, how can you keep track of us? Well, first of all, check out our webpage, ThursdayNightTailgate.com. On there, you'll be able to stay up to date with what our guest schedule looks like. And we've got links back to our good friends over on Podbean, so you can stream or download any of our archive episodes for free from there. On Twitter and Instagram, you can follow me at CT Mascaro. Bob is at Bob_Lazzari, and the show is at TNT Podcast. We also have our own individual Facebook pages, so look us up there and give us a follow and interact with us there. We've got a page also set up for the show, Thursday Night Tailgate. Give us a like on that. We'd really appreciate that very much. Bob, take us home, my friend.
Okay, Chris, thanks. We'll talk next week. And we want to also thank our great announcer, Joe Lajanusa, for the terrific job he always does with our intro and ads. We also want to shout out to Kyle Turley and the Kyle Turley Band for the upcoming outro music. On behalf of myself and Chris, we want to thank everyone tonight for listening. We appreciate you the very most. And until next week, good night, Kevin, and good night, Terry. We miss you guys.